Today's sort of a quick tip on how to make your camp life more comfortable, and that is tying up your ridgelines. Now, a while ago I showed the figure eight pattern, using that on your hand for tangle-free cordage, and that has proven very, very well over the years, so we're gonna continue on with that. But there's another little twist you can add to that with your ridgelines, because we all know that ridgelines have hardware on them, so it might be prussics or it might be some type of metal clip like a wasp from Dutchware. Anything like that is gonna be a along that ridgeline. So how do we deal with that when winding it up on our hand? Let's look at it right now. Now, there's always the option to take all of your hardware, so in my case, just my prussics, and slide them all the way up to wherever I'm gonna start my line. In my case, a bowline knot, and then I can come here and start my figure eight process for tangle-free cordage. The only downfall that I personally don't like about this is when I'm gonna set this up, especially if it's cold and my fingers are numb, or it's wet, or I have gloves on, now I need to run my hardware all the way across my ridge line and I'm messing around with it. I'd rather just prep it the second way, which I'm gonna show you here in a second, in order to be more efficient. So here's how we're gonna start this. We're gonna take our end tie out. In my case, a bowline knot. I'm gonna hang it over my hands, and I'm going to start my figure eight process, okay? Just our normal figure eight process. Now, you see right here, my prussic is down in here. So I don't wanna continue this, because what happens is as you do this, see that prussic cord's now getting tangled up in everything else. So what we're going to do is we're gonna take this prussic when we get to the point that we come upon it, we're gonna slide it up so it is on top of my tie out. So you see how I just slid this up? Okay, now it's on top with my tie out loop. So I'm gonna just continue my figure eight, keeping everything organized. Now I come across my next prussic. So at this point, I'm gonna slide this one up. So you see I'm keeping all my hardware up at the top of my ridge line when I'm tying this out. So everything is up top, my loop's up top, my prussics are up top, and now I could tie this out. And of course, when you get to the end, then you can just wrap this around one or two times and you are golden, you're good to go. So now the beauty of this is when I tie out my end, I just grab that loop because I can see it very quickly and easily. I either use a marline spike hitch or feed this through, whatever I want to do, but I start to pull across my cord like this. Okay, you could see it's all coming out, and right there my prussic comes free. So it's nice and simple, okay? It's not getting tangled up, everything's going, boom. Second prussic, keep going, and now we're all freed up, okay? So easy breezy. And that's it. That's a very simple, easy trick. And it might seem like, well, yeah, that's just common sense to do that. But they're the little things that take you from just a normal outdoorsman to a great woodsman. So you compound all these little tips and tricks. You add 15 little tips and tricks to your arsenal per trip, it's just taking you to that next level. It's making your camp life that much easier. So give it a shot, see what you think, and as always, check us out at coalcrackerbushcraft.com, and until next video, stay in the woods.